It's great to have you with us for the opening match of the 2022 Women's Asian Cup. It features China versus Chinese Taipei from the Mumbai Football Arena, situated on the west coast of India. In the Asian rankings, it's 5th versus 8th. This is a Group A fixture. The other teams in the group are the hosts India and debutants Iran. They play later on today in Navi Mumbai. Sadly, due to COVID-19 restrictions, all games at this tournament will be played behind closed doors. It's mid-afternoon in Mumbai. Kickoff is 15:30 local time. We're in the warmest part of the day at 29 degrees. There is, though, a very welcome gentle breeze coming off the Arabian Sea, which is just over 2 miles away. Fitness and conditioning may well be a factor, especially later on in proceedings. The pitch looks absolutely magnificent, and we are moments away from the opening game of this tournament. It's the start of a new era for China. They've won this competition 8 times. They are making their 15th appearance. In the early years, they had a 43-game unbeaten run stretching from 1986 to 2001. But currently, they're in the doldrums after a really poor Olympic Games in Japan last summer. They have changed their coach, former player Shui Qingxia, taking over in November. She says they're in it to win it. We're about to find out if she has had enough time to impose her ideas and style on the squad. Chinese Taipei were the first team to arrive in India, and they've had success here before. They beat India in 1979 to lift the trophy. One of three they've won. They bring a little bit of form to the competition. They won both their qualifying games without conceding a goal. Those games against Laos and Bahrain were back in October. Their coach is a former Japan international, Eshigo Katsuya. He's been in charge since 2019. Two have played each other 9 times. China have the upper hand. They've won 8 of those meetings, including the only time they've encountered each other in the Asian Cup. The last game between the two was in February 2020. China recorded their biggest ever victory, winning 5-0. So a tall order for Chinese Taipei, but they have the more settled lineup. Their preparations have been smoother, and there is much less pressure on them. Those of us that have been to China know how much sport means to the country. More so when they're competing on the international stage. This is our first look at the teams. China in red, Chinese Taipei white with light blue shorts.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome the teams of China and Taipei.
COVID protocols being followed. Team go first. Here come Chinese Taipei. It's a spicy one to open the tournament with. Geographically close. There are seven changes from China's last competitive game, the big loss to the Netherlands at the Olympic Games in Japan last summer. Four-four-two for both sides today. There's huge experience up front for China. Shan Shan and Jia Hui have 254 caps between them. Five substitutes are allowed. Tung Jia Li, who plays for Tottenham Hotspur, is back in the squad after missing those Olympic Games. The referee is Ebarami Naidu from Singapore, who is a software engineer when not officiating. Three alterations for Chinese Taipei from their last competitive game, a 2-0 win over Bahrain in qualifying last October. With both teams lining up in a similar formation, expect it to be an even match, especially in midfield early on. Xu Yiun on the left side is the most experienced player. Amongst the substitutes, Li Shuqin is the most likely source of goals from the Chinese Taipei bench. She has 9 in 27 appearances. Yeah. So a final huddle for Chinese Taipei. So too China. Very important not to lose your first game in tournament football, but with only 4 teams in the group, it's important to win your first game and get things off to a flyer. We are underway in the 2022 Women's Asian Cup. And China with some early possession. Jia Yue. Zhao She. China fullbacks pushing up immediately. Li Na. Little bit of space for Lin Yan. Now first touch on the ball for Chinese Taipei. But they have given it away. And a lot of time on the ball for China already. Way. Flick didn't quite work. Well read. Too many options. Look at the pressing from China. Really energetic early on. And the referee points to the spot. Less than 90 seconds on the clock. Thumbs up to the assistant referee, who may well have had a part in calling that. Perhaps the referee unsighted. Here we go. Yen Xin, the offender. And China have an opportunity to make an electric start to this tournament. Chung Se Yu is in goal. Referee is happy. And easily done by Shuang. And China take the lead. What a start for them. They set their stall out early on, moving the fullbacks up, trying to take the game to Chinese Taipei, and an early reward. Keeper went the wrong way. Goal number 35 for Wong Shuang. Confidently taken penalty, and China are in the driving seat, and there's less than 3 minutes on the clock. Dream start for the Steel Roses. And they will go hunting for more. First time ball changes the pace, and Chinese Taipei almost caught out again. Little bit loose at the back from Wei Ru, almost giving the ball away to Lin Yan. Chung Se Yu beaten in the opening couple of minutes of this game. Yu Shen is the willing runner. Not much in the way of support. Yen Xin is closest to her. 4 against 2 in that corner. So whatever game plan Chinese Taipei had, as we look at the calmly taken penalty, whatever game plan they had has, if not gone out the window, it's going to have to change. They're going to have to be perhaps a bit more positive than they wanted to be early in this game, early in this tournament. It is a blow. China controlling the ball and in control 5 minutes in. Zhang Yi has plenty of time, winning her 71st cap today. It's an experience through the spine of the China side. Already shaping up to be a long afternoon for Chinese Taipei. They can't keep hold of the ball. They're having to work really hard. Yi Yun. Ball stays in play. First time ball to the far post. And Shuang, why not? Really good pace to China's passing. Zipping it around. China Super League finished in early December, so these players have had a good while to get together. And coach Shui Chung-Xia has had a little bit of time to work with them. And, as you can see so far, their movement and their passing is pretty crisp. Is the goal scorer. First touch wasn't the best one. It's hung up at the back post, but that will be a goal kick. Ranked 19 in the world, China, fifth in Asia. Chinese Taipei 39 in the world and 8th in Asia. Just a little bit of a loose touch from Shan Shan and the door was closed. Chinese Taipei on the back foot once more. Wei Ru with the clearance. Chuan. Li Na. Time for Zhao She. Well worked, and space on the right hand side, and the cross is a good one, and in it goes. Shan Shan the scorer, and we have played less than 10 minutes and China in complete control. Really good team goal, good move, firm header off the post, over the line, 2-0. Chinese Taipei really up against it now. terrific start from China. They have looked sharp. Too sharp for Chinese Taipei, who've hardly had a touch on the ball. And when they have had a touch, they've given it away and given away carelessly once more. Third goal of her international career for Wang Shanshan, making her 145th appearance. Chen Li Na Wei. Li Na once more, and China knocking it around at will. Chen to Shin. That ball is on again. Another cross, another shot. Save this time. Shuang with the effort. And China come again. It's relentless. Chen once more. That right-hand side for China is gold mine at the moment. Chinese Taipei have to sort out their left back position. There's just too much space over there. Zhao Xie. Once again, no white shirt. And they're in again on the right hand side. Zhao Xie wins the ball. China have it back. Work some space. Near side for a change. Wei. Li Na. Jia Yue. Chen. Another very good pass from her. Shin. Gao Chen once more. Has to go back this time. She's been very progressive in that central midfield area. Chinese Taipei in the low block. China can afford to be patient now. Loose pass. And the move breaks down. Won their last two games, their last two competitive games without conceding, but there has been a rude awakening here in Mumbai in the hands of their great rivals, China. And there is a long way to go. As a goal kick. Shanshan, I think, felt it. May well have been a corner, but they're in cruise control, so no drama. Again, giving the ball away. Lin Yan. Trying to finish third in this tournament last time out, which qualified them for this tournament. As mentioned, the Chinese Taipei qualified, winning both their qualifying games. A new era for football, women's football in China, is off to a great start. China team will have terrific fitness and keep going, even though it is a warm one. Jia Yu, Li Na, Xiao Xiao. Lina drops back, makes herself available, and here she is. The deeper of the two central midfielders. And again, she drops back. Gao Chen looking for space, instead it goes wide to Wei. She runs into traffic, retains possession, clever ball. 1-2 doesn't quite come off. Lin Yan wins a corner though. Good energy from China. Changing the pace with first time balls. Just look a little bit quicker, a bit sharper than Chinese Taipei. Sun in the face of the defenders. Chung Shin prepares to swing this corner over. Carooms off the first defender, and the header is only just wide from Gao Chen. Pinged in. Timed her jump really well. Had to adjust her position. Didn't miss by much. There's Jia Yu. Taipei trying to press. 4 or 5 in the China half. A little bit of hesitation from the goalkeeper, then she decides to go long. Shan Shan chasing. Shin there as well. Jiafei. Here's Shan Shan. She points to the quadrant, and so does the assistant referee. Let's get out with the second goal. Near post it goes. Chinese Taipei alert to it, but they've conceded another corner. This is the first of two big international tournaments in India this year. The FIFA Under-17 World Cup will be held in October. Goalkeeper comes and punches. China have it back. Pressure still on. Chuang was offside. This kick from Yenping almost put her side in trouble. Was out of play rather than offside. Chinese Taipei restart the game. All hands to the pump for them. It's good work. Li Na covering. A little bit of holding. Jiahui. Li Na with time. Gets it back, still has time. What a pass. It was just a hesitation from Chongxin. Really pinged it out there. Chin felt that perhaps the Chinese Taipei player may well have intercepted that. That was an excellent pass, not quite reaching its intended target. As Wei forward, given away. Energetic first 20 minutes or so from Zhong Lin Yan. Li Na has seen a lot of the ball. And these two haven't had too much to do. Deflected. From Wei. So the top two from each group, plus the two best placed third, go to the quarterfinals, and then the four semi-finalists earn direct entry to next year's World Cup in Australia and New Zealand. So massive incentive to reach the final four of this tournament. Xu Yiyun quite catch up with the ball. Very difficult opening quarter for Chinese Taipei. Conceding twice within the first 10 minutes. Chen. For her, which is forward. Shuang, good work. They're in again. The pullback! Wei picks up the loose ball. Li Na seems to be in the right place at the right time. Chen, that was a risky pass. They've given it away. They worked hard to put the ball carrier under pressure. And the passing error comes to nothing. China keeping up their excellent tempo. It's going to be a worry for Ishigo Katsura, Chinese Taipei coach. Strong challenge, and China have it back. Shan Shan lurking. Clever. Gets it back. Pass is slightly overhead. All good interplay from China. Sending a message to others in the group and also in the tournament. We have come to play. The coach, Shui Chun-Xia, the top of the program. I thought she may have been a little bit optimistic, saying they were coming to win the trophy, but certainly made an impressive start. They mean business. Forward again from Chen. Doesn't quite work this time. Chuan. They want offside. Flag stays down. Keepers come. Cross couldn't find a red shirt. And anywhere will do for Sin Yun. Desperate defending. To get it clear, but it ends up in another China throw and taken quickly. Oh dear. It's another corner given away needlessly. It's just not going Chinese Taipei's way at the moment. They are under pressure. They're being forced into making errors. And China are turning the screw. Established a rhythm straight away. They've had a lot of possession. And they have scored twice. Chuan. Another header, one in the Chinese Taipei penalty area. China will come back and start again with Wei. There's a high boot in the area. Chen Wei apologises. Unintentional, had her eye on the ball. Suchin is okay. Lovely first touch from Shuang. Lin Yan. Li Na. A little bit higher up the pitch. Xiao She. Has been the odd misplaced pass. Here's an opportunity for Chinese Taipei. Yen Ping in support. That's a loose pass as well. A little bit of a ragged passage of play. From China, perhaps just for the first time, half an hour played, a little loss of concentration from China. No real danger from Yu Shen. Chun Xia, the China coach. in the technical area for the first time, just sensing that her team may have dropped a bit. And now they have to defend a set piece. So first real test for the China defence. Coming again. Still a good possession for Chinese Taipei in China's last third. Just one in the area, two now. That's ambitious. Difficult ball to control. Pressure is relieved for China. Just the second cap from the goalkeeper to you. Her previous cap in April last year in a 2-2 draw against the Korea Republic. So a little bit of inexperience in goal, but yet to be tested. Linar helping it on. Again, the first time pass, just changing the tempo of the move. Gao Chen. Really good pass. She just sees the picture. Here she is again. Throw it. Just in case you were wondering, there's no VAR until the quarterfinals. So those of you who perhaps don't like it can enjoy a bit of football without it. Another good pass. Good defending though that time. Too physical, says the referee. So Chen not penalised. So what do China have up their sleeves from this free kick? You've seen the corners being pinged in. Chong So-yu in the Chinese Taipei goal has to get her wall right here. Left foot of Shuang. To trouble the goalkeeper. 2 or 3 steps to her left. China throw. China's Taipei trying to get further up the field. Just to get some numbers up there and put the China defenders under pressure. Right. Nina Wei in field. Nice take from Shuang. Really enjoying watching the two China midfielders, central midfielders. Nina and Chen. They are being given quite a lot of time to operate, but always available, complementing each other. Chen's passing forward especially impressive. And they're running the game. Chinese Taipei have to find a way to disrupt that, get in amongst them in midfield. Just too much time. Can't work that time. Chinese Taipei can break. Can they make the most of this? No, they can't. It's hard yards. Taipei. Less than 10 minutes to go to the break. They are still in this game though at 2-0. If they can keep it like that until half time. Coach can maybe make a couple of adjustments, a tweak here or there, just to give China more problems. Su Shen with the run. Wei is covering. Lovely touch from Shuang. Quite going to work that one. Quite have the same sharpness they had in the first 15 or 20 minutes or so, but they are in complete control. Chinese Taipei have threatened a couple of times. Just a little bit wasteful when they do have the ball, but they are under tremendous pressure. Shin has time to turn. This touch. Chinese Taipei have it back. Can they keep hold of it and build something here? Forward it goes. Yu Shen, a willing runner, but very little service for her so far. Being marked by two central defenders, very difficult life up front for Chinese Taipei. Wei withstands the challenge, finds Li Na. The target. She's been a bundle of energy. That's left hand side for China. Chen. Super ball. Picked up by Shin. Lingyan. Two for company. Goal kick, says the referee. competition being played across three cities on the west coast of India, Mumbai, Navi Mumbai, and Pune. Oh, mistake. Shen has the corner. Just the hint of an opening there. China's concentration wavering again. And it's another set piece opportunity for Chinese Taipei. China will kick themselves if they concede here. 5 minutes before half time, they've been in complete control of this game. He's into a good area. Way forward. Appeal for offside. The flag does go up. It's Lin Yen. Just straight beyond the last defender. Much more of the game being played in China's half in the last 10 minutes or so. China's intensity and concentration has dropped off a little bit. Kasua, the Chinese Taipei coach, perhaps senses that. Trying to get his team to play higher up the pitch. He keeps a watchful eye. No, it didn't take a nick on the way through. It is a goal kick. From Li No, right under the nose of the referee. The Chinese Taipei make something of this as we move towards half time. Plenty of red shirts around. Shin is fouled. Chinese Taipei coach has something to build on at half-time here. His team played with a bit more confidence in the last 15 minutes of this first half. China giving it away again. Li Na takes over. Excellent pass. And the first time ball in the middle is a good one. One was lurking. Just the 1 minute of stoppage time. The game has flowed pretty well. China half, but it's just been a little bit too much of that. That's impatience. Just keep hold of the ball, find the gaps, find the space. But shooting from that range, it's playing into China's hands. And that is half time. And China lead Chinese Taipei by 2-0. And both of them coming early in the piece. The first, a penalty very early in the game, converted by Wang Shuang. And then, just a couple of minutes later, across from the right, excellent header from Wang Shanshan. That was 2-0 after just 10 minutes of the game. China were relentless in coming forward, but then in the last 15 minutes or so, there was a glimpse of what Chinese Taipei could do. Too often they were wasteful in possession. They didn't have much of the ball, as you can see from that stat at the top. 73% of the ball for China, just 27% for Chinese Taipei. They do have something to build on for the second half, and they are still very much in this game. But at half time, in the opening match of this tournament, it's China 2, Chinese Taipei 0.
Okay. करतोय का मी ते मेन्यू पण ऑपरेट होत नाही आहे माझ्या म्हणजे आतलं सर्किट आहे ना ते काहीतरी हल्लंय काहीतरी झालेलं आहे. स्पेअर नाही आहे कॅमेरा. हे तिकडे व्यवस्थित दिसतंय आउटपुट.
Welcome back to the Mumbai Football Arena. Chinese Taipei already out on the field, and here are China, who are leading 2-0 after a fantastic start to the game and the tournament, scoring twice in the first 10 minutes. There must have been a lot to talk about for Chinese Taipei at half-time. They did come into the game for the last 15 minutes or so of that first half, showed just a little bit of impatience, got to try and force China into making mistakes, trying to keep hold of the football, get China to do the work. They looked very sharp in the first 15 minutes or so. Passing was crisp, finishing was good. Jia Yui giving the lecture as the first of the substitutes comes on. Wu Chengshu can play left side of midfield. Also on Yao Lingwei. So we'll have to see where they slot into the team shape. But by far the most impressive part of China's game in that first half was the two central midfielders. And we are underway in the second half of this opening game of the 20th Women's Asian Cup. Chinese Taipei looking to overturn a 2-0 deficit. Just need something to get back into this game. Put China under pressure. See how they react when they've been rattled. China have it back. Side. Ling Wei, the other substitute, who's wearing 16, taking off a more central position. Over the top of the door. A painful one for Yenping. Treatment required. This year's tournament expanded from 8 to 12 teams. Runs from the 20th of January to the 6th of February. 17 days. To continue. Tu Chu takes over. Xiao Xie. Xin involved as well. Forward it goes, laid off by Shan Shan. Xin Yu with the interception. Stepping in Ling Wei. Accurate pass, Shuang. Good defending. Picked up again though by Ling Wei. Already making her presence felt after coming on as a second half substitute. From Xin Yun. In the early years of this tournament, Chinese Taipei did very well, won it three times. But their last triumph in the Asian Cup was back in 1981. China took over and absolutely dominated. Here they are in 2022. China in the driving seat in this opening match of the tournament. 25 games plus playoffs, because there is a fifth World Cup spot up for grabs, and that kind of depends on how Australia get on in the tournament, Australia being the hosts of the World Cup next year. As I mentioned before, four semi-finalists earn direct entry into the World Cup. Misplaced header. Shanshan collects. Outnumbered. Shuang in the middle. China have a throw. Good pressure on the ball from China, having given it away. Making sure that Chinese Taipei couldn't spring a counter-attack. And Shen restarts the game. Yun. Plenty back for China. Forward by Jia Yuyi. Ping working hard as the lone runner up front, but there's plenty of time and space here for Jia Hui. Shuang clips it into the box. Jing Shu couldn't collect. China have it back though. Turning the screw once more. Jia Hui. Chen let it run and runs into trouble until the referee brings it back for a foul on China's number 23, who is really good in that first half. Real eye for a pass. Very progressive player, wanting to move the ball forward at every opportunity. Here she is again. Way. Really solid tackle. Excellent work. Until the final ball, which was pretty much the story of that last 15 minutes of the first half, was asking an awful lot of the front runner. China had players back to cover anyway. Since China last won the tournament, having won it eight times. The rest of Asia has caught up with them. Yinping gives the ball away. Little bit of time for Shuang. Lovely first touch. And a goal, a third goal for China. Chong Xin. With the finish, excellent build-up, and China, like they did in the first half, have scored early. Touch to steady herself, ignored the defender flying in, and found the back of the net. Chongxin with her third goal of her international career. It's Taipei looking to strike back early on. This is that goal makes life very difficult for them. 2-0, very much in the game, but climb is even steeper now. Chasing is Yinping. Yiting has the opportunity to cross, and it's a good one. Flicked away, though. He's the scorer of the third goal for China, who commits a foul. So a set-piece opportunity for Chinese Taipei, and they're going to have to start making better use of these set pieces and putting some pressure on China. There will be another injury delay. The second game of the tournament takes place a little bit later, also in Group A. Eagerly anticipated clash between the host India, who've been working really hard preparing for this tournament. And they're up against the debutants, Iran. Their preparations haven't been quite so smooth. The host country hoping for a really impressive first outing from India. A lot of expectation. An easy game against Iran. They like to play on the counter-attack. That's to come. In the meantime, Lee Chin is lining up this free kick. Down to 10. In attendance as well. First defender heads it away. Chinese Taipei have to be careful here. That's a clever pass. And now this is one-on-one. Good defending in the end. With the throw, Chinese Taipei almost caught out there from the free kick. Chen moves it on. Chen Xin gives the ball away needlessly. A goal kick. To Chinese Taipei. Two goals in the first half, one in this second period. Yen. It's only Yen Ping in the box. But better from Chinese Taipei. Too close to the goalkeeper. Chen Xin, the goal scorer. Xiao Xia. Ying Wei, the substitute. Zhang Wei. And progress is blocked. China substitute. Li Mengwen. That will be a corner to China. Mengwen having her 11th cap. Opportunity for the China coach to give some of the players not in the starting 11, some tournament minutes, get them up to speed. Injuries and suspensions could well kick in later, and if you've got match fit, match ready players to replace those who are unavailable for whatever reason. An hour gone. And China re-establishing control of this game with the third goal. Just 9 or so minutes after the restart. Zhao Yui covering and allowing goalkeeper Xu Yu to pick it up and set off another China attack. Into the game, ambitious ball and easily intercepted. Two is a little bit untidy. Shan Shan going in. A little bit of fortune in China getting it back, but they've lost it again. Chinese Taipei can't take advantage, and the momentum is now with China. Ling Wei. And again, Shuang. Pass took out two defenders. Meng Wen. Settles for a corner. Japan are the defending champions, beating Australia to retain the title. One of the powerhouses of Asian football, goalkeeper comes and doesn't get a hand to it. Awkward ball to deal with. Chinese Taipei, nobody there in red to take advantage of the ball to the back post. China free kick. Controlled performance so far. Steel Roses. Given away though. Ambitious covering was Gao Chen. Goalkeeper under pressure. Keeps a cool, does well. Chen forward. The flick almost comes off. Chinese Taipei have it back. Flag goes up. A change for Chinese Taipei. So Chen coming on. Mentioned her in the preamble. She is a goal threat. 9 in 27 appearances. Chinese Taipei beefing up their attack in search of a goal. Yinxin just keeps the ball in play. Yinxin has lost out though. Shan Shan chases and collects. keeps the ball in play. Shuang is up with her. Zhongshu. This is really good from China. Meng Wen just is slightly misplaced. China recover the ball though. Ling Wei coming on at half time. Hard working substitute. Shuang. Chen helps it on. Chinese Taipei set in their defensive formation, so China go back and build again, come again. First time pass doesn't come off. Su Qin has given it away through the legs of Li Ping. Play brought back though for a free kick, I think, to China. Indeed it is. Was that a drop ball? And Ray had to go back. Jia Yue. Zhongxin. Ling Wei under pressure gives the ball away. Retrieved by Yu Shen, but given straight back to China. Shan Shan. Chen. Ling Wei. Meng Wen. China can take their time. Ling Wei. It's controlled by Shan Shan. A little bit of relief for Zhong Seyu and her defense. Touch was important there. Shan Shan guides the header down. Zhongshu times the pass well. Oh, and the cross has come all the way through, and it is number four. Second of the game for Shuang. Three defenders missed it. 68 played, and China make it 4-0. Calamitous defending. The feint, the shot, the goal. No way back, surely, now for Chinese Taipei. Chinese Taipei must keep going. Need something to take into their next game. As we have a look at the goal again, onto the favoured left foot. And once that happened, it was only going to end up in one place. Next up for Chinese Taipei is India on the 23rd of January. And then they finish against Iran on the 26th. trying to try and avoid a cricket score here. Just keep going, keep their heads up. Throw goes to China. Chong Shin, scorer of the third goal, working hard to ensure that China retained possession from the throw-in, and here she is again. And another injury to a Chinese Taipei player, Yen Xin this time. And was falling on. Referee, I think, has decided that she's off the pitch, so play can carry on. Shikara Katsue. His team are under the cosh. Well. Yenshin getting treatment off the pitch. China come again. Shan Shan. It's all China. Zhao She just got so much time on the ball. Chongqing. The through ball. Shan Shan denied this time. We're into the last 20 minutes. And an excellent first showing for China. Tournament. To a good start. The goal's flowing. It's a good pass. Li Qin. Covering is Jia Yue. Lots of time for Shan Shan. Control for Yen Ting. Getting away. Shan Shan. They want offside. Play goes on. The cross comes in. Well headed away. Chinese Taipei having trouble staying on their feet. Just grateful that the ball has gone out of play. Forward coming on for China. And a change too for Chinese Taipei. Wu Kai-ching coming on for the last 17 minutes or so. Wrong. Playing the 1-2, keeper's ball. Looking for the early release, but China were already funneling back, making sure there were no gaps in defence for Chinese Taipei to spring a counter-attack. strong header in central defence. Xiong with a rare loose pass. Su Chen. Kai Ching can't find a way through. Zhao Yue forward. It'll fall for Xiong. Li Ying made the run. And here she is. Oh, and back off the woodwork. Another excellent move from China. Really good pass. Goalkeeper beaten. Back off the frame of the goal. Substitutes have really perked up China. Maintaining the tempo. But as we saw in the first half, Chinese Taipei came into it later on. But they were still in the game at 2-0, at 4-0. They need something special. Deflected into the path of Li Ying. And goes for goal with her left foot this time. Sliced. Next up for China is Iran on Wednesday, and then 3 days later, on the 26th of January, they play India. That looks good. India versus China, perhaps to decide the group. Long way to go yet. Way. Chen, not quite so influential in this second half. Gao Chen was running the game with Li Na in the first half. Li Na going off at half time. Scored two more goals. They've had an awful lot of the ball. Zhongshu. Challenge from Wei Ru. Final substitution for China. One of the goal scorers, Chun Xin, is going off. Get a look at Tong Jali, who's coming on for her 71st cap. She plays for Tottenham in the top division in England. A late arrival to the camp. Played against West Ham last weekend in a 1-1 draw. Given an opportunity this afternoon, and have a luxury for a forward to come on with your team 4-0 up. No pressure on the ball. Now there is a little bit. Lingwei. A little bit aimless. Sorting it out is Wang Shuang. Chuang still busy. Just can't get it clear, Chinese Taipei. China come again. Just over 10 minutes to go. And they're looking for more goals. Jali will keep it in. Xiaoxi. Intricate passing on the edge of the area. Ling Wei steps in to regain possession. Shuang trying to control it. Loses out. Ling Wei steps in once more. Chen forward. Didn't quite come off for Shuang. China still probing. Referee plays on and off the line. Jali denied. The goalkeeper may have just got a touch to it with her left boot, but it was certainly going in until the intervention of the defender from behind the goalkeeper. Only been on the pitch a couple of minutes. Close to a goal. Stoppage for an injury to a Chinese Taipei player. It hasn't been overly physical, but China certainly the stronger of the two. Sin Yun hobbles off and play set to continue. It'll restart with a China throw on that far side. Chinese Taipei temporarily down to 10 players. Chen still directing operations. Ling Wei. Chen once more, looking for the forward ball. There was nothing on. Jali. She's made an impact since coming on. And that wasn't very far wide either. Well, pleasing so far all round for China. Took an early grip on the game. With two goals in the first 10 minutes. Increase their lead 10 minutes or so after half time. It's given them the luxury of bringing on substitutes to get a feel for the tournament, get a feel for the conditions, get a feel for the pitch. So far, so good for China in this opening game of the Women's Asian Cup. Setting the tone for the tournament. Yinping. Li Qin's pass diverted out of play. Tinchi. Easily read. Free kick goes to Chinese Taipei. Deep was high. Less than 5 minutes to go of normal time. Mumbai Football Arena, home of Mumbai City FC. They play in the Indian Super League and who are in the AFC Champions League. When fans are in attendance, it holds 18,000. Small but perfectly formed. As previously mentioned, with an excellent playing surface. China, especially in the first 20 minutes, were really zipping the ball around. Li Ying, who's chasing after the goalkeeper, has certainly made her presence felt. Different kind of forward, strong in the air, more physical. Something else for the Chinese Taipei defenders to deal with. Jia Yui there first, finds Wei, Ling Wei, Xiao She. Been pretty solid, those two, in central defence. Really been tested. But they've kept it nice and tidy. Gao Chen forward. Jia Li helping it on. Wei wants it back and gets it back. Excellent running off the ball from Jia Li. Tightly marked. Chen. Li Ying was the target. Aimless punt upfield. Yen Ping still working hard, the Chinese Taipei number 7. Joyless afternoon for her so far. China can come again. Wei. Wang Wen with the nutmeg, and still Jia Li. Wei overhits the cross. That was a little bit tired, that one. Certainly put in a shift. The China midfield has worked really hard. They've stayed on top of Chinese Taipei throughout the game. Ling Wei forward. No whistle. Wei anchoring the midfield. Here she is again. Last minute of normal time. Li Ying the target, and she had strayed a touch offside. Chun Se-yu will clear her lines. Forward from Lee Chin. Jia Li will keep it in play. Jia Yue. Way back to Xia She. We will have 3 minutes of stoppage time to play at the end of this opening game of the Women's Asian Cup. And China have been impressive throughout the game. They've kept the tempo up really well in this second half. And they are looking for a fifth. Jia Li. Shuang forward. Surrounded by white shirts. Xiao She. Seen her that far upfield, I don't think, for the whole game. Shuang. Score of two of the four goals. And the header is easily grabbed. Way with the cross. Chung Shu. Just slightly off balance. Was on target. Straightforward for Chung So-yu in the Chinese Taipei goal. A minute and a half to go in this game. Thought it was a China throw. Assistant referee disagreed. Possible opening here. Su Chin. They've lost it. Ming Wei. Side flag is up. China can just play out time now. Really good start for them. They have flexed their muscles here in Mumbai. All the other teams who are watching this opening game will have sat up and taken notice. Too early to say that China are back, but they're on the way back. And the referee brings an end to the game. A one-sided game and a comfortable victory for China over Chinese Taipei in the opening match of the 20th Women's Asian Cup. China off to a flyer, won a penalty in the second minute of the game, converted by Wan Shuang, sending the goalkeeper the wrong way. And then 6 minutes after that, Wang Shanshan with a header from across from the right, hit the post and went in. It was 2-0 at half-time. Chinese Taipei had come back to it in the last 10 minutes or so of that first half, but they conceded again 9 minutes after the restart. Chung Shin made it 3-0. And then on 69, some poor defending let in Wang Shuang for the fourth. Final score, China 4, Chinese Taipei 0.